9月9日，少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 与美国联邦贸易委员会消费者保护局联合召开网络会议，就日益激增的加密货币的骗局及其如何防范这一话题进行探讨。据联邦贸易委员会 FTC 统计数据表明，自2021年以来，加密货币骗局造成的损失超过10亿美元。这种骗局通常是通过社交媒体上发生的。必须注意的是，加密货币一旦交易就无法追回现金。
You know, trying to use cryptocurrency as a currency comes with all of the same issues as a kind of a traditional currency. You know, it has to be stable. There has to be enough of it in circulation. You have to be able to access it when you need it, and you need to be able to rely on its value. And I think that all of those things fell apart pretty quickly. And somebody else asked a question about.How does cryptocurrency hold its value? Well, as we've seen, it doesn't hold its value at a very steady rate, right? It jumps up and down a lot.
联邦贸易委员会消费者和商业教育部门消费者教育专家 Christina Marwenda 介绍了加密货币骗局的五种套路：一是投资诈欺 （investment-related fraud）， 二是爱情骗子 （romance）， 三是假冒政府或知名商业 （business and government imposters）， 四是求职工作网站。Job scams， 五是邮件勒索 blackmail。他强调，如遇这些欺诈行为，可向 FTC 的网站投诉，以防止加密货币骗局的蔓延。
You know, our general advice is that if you see a tweet, a text, or email, or some type of message on social media, especially one that tells you to pay with cryptocurrency, know that it's always a scam. If you're interested in an investment type of opportunity,just know that a lot of these scams start off with tips or secrets on like online message boards. There's always not going to be a whole lot of detail about what you're investing in because scammers are always trying to get you to be emotionally invested in it and almost do like a fast yes and a slow no.If you know what I mean. So that's our advice. And also, please report it to reportfraud.ftc.gov,which is where you can report cryptocurrency scams.
在本次网络会议上，来自田纳西州孟菲斯市学区的一名教师现身说法，介绍了他在社交媒体 Facebook 上遇到加密货币诈骗的经历。在美国因爱情而被骗取加密货币的例子，通常发生于20至49岁的中青年之间。在一段感情中向另一半介绍加密货币，并要求对方投入大量资金，这就是通常所说的杀猪盘，需谨防受骗。全美电视台记者洛杉矶采访报道。